You good? All right, I want to brief all of you on a very significant gun arrest and drug arrest that we made Tuesday night around 9 o'clock, Southeast Baltimore, 100 block of North Kenwood Street. And before I get into the details, I really want to underscore how important this seizure is. Despite all the challenges and all the issues of running a big city police department, one thing that we are relentlessly focused on is going after illegal guns and illegal gun offenders in Baltimore. And I don't know how much more to make that clearer than today, when we're announcing the arrest of two individuals for having an arsenal. I can't think of any other way to say it than an arsenal of weapons inside their home, along with drugs. It happened through an undercover investigation where detectives bought, in an undercover capacity, narcotics out of this house. That led to the execution of a search and seizure warrant at the residence. And when we went in there, we found three handguns, three assault weapons. One of those assault weapons was an AK-47. We had an AR-15 style weapon. And I want to bring up Sergeant Kowalczyk because I want to explain what that means in terms of the danger to the public, also the danger to the police officers that these weapons could have posed. The individuals also had body armor. So the suspect, who we'll identify in a minute, was arrested. He's a felon in possession of body armor. And this latest seizure just underscores our commitment again to going after. So, Sergeant.
So every day that we're out on the street, we're aware of the fact that we might encounter somebody who's armed with a weapon. When you're facing somebody that's armed with assault-style weapons, in this case it was two AK-47s and an AR-15, that's capable of defeating the body armor that we wear. So that puts our lives in even greater jeopardy when you're confronting an armed person. When you add the fact that they had bullet-resistant vests, which would be capable of stopping our rounds if we were to become engaged in a firefight, you understand the danger that the detectives who were investigating this case were faced with, and that when our SWAT team made entry on this, the danger that they faced, the potential danger that they faced, we're aware of that danger when we come to work every day. That's what we signed up for. We know that that's a part of the job. You're not really prepared to meet people that are as heavily armed as these two were, with body armor and ready to take action the way that it appears that these two were. So it's a significant danger that our officers face, and they did an excellent job in this case.
And guys, we sent you the warrant. Over 1 pound of marijuana was seized from the location, along with, like I said, a small arsenal of weapons. Fransico Milos is the suspect's name. We also arrested his female accomplice, and the investigation is ongoing. There are pieces of it that are still being worked on by detectives and prosecutors. Sir.
Quick question. What made these guns illegal? Is it the type of guns or is it the connection?
It's not the type of weapons. This individual is a felon. He's a convicted felon out of the state of Florida, I believe, and he is prohibited from possessing these types of weapons. He's also prohibited from possessing a bulletproof vest. And he was dealing drugs out of his house.
Do you know how the guns were purchased?
No, not yet. Not yet. He did tell investigators that he totally admitted that these were his drugs. He admitted that these were his guns, and he told detectives the reason why he had these types of weapons is that he was preparing for, quote, the war. When we pressed him on that and asked him who the war was against, he declined to answer. We're lucky that this war wasn't against the people of Baltimore, that he wasn't supplying, hopefully wasn't supplying illegal guns on our streets. That's the part that we're trying to figure out next. But again, he was arrested. We did recover significant amount of weapons and drugs.
Where was he arrested?
133 North Kenwood is the actual address.
Is that an apartment building?
House. It's a residence.
Okay. How did he get on your radar?
Through an undercover investigation. Okay.
And some bullets.
7,000 bullets, I think. What was it, sir?
7,500.
7,500 rounds of ammunition. Again, I think given the climate that we're in, given some of the national tragedies that we've seen, it's troublesome to hear that someone would have this type of weaponry in their homes while selling drugs, also equipped with bulletproof equipment. I think we just heard again that the dangers that could have had to police and, all, of course, the city as a whole.
When the raid occurred, were the officers performing the raid, were they aware of the weaponry inside?
Yes, the raid, we had intelligence based on the undercover investigation that took place. And because of the intelligence that we had, we had called in our SWAT team to execute the raid. They are highly trained in weapons and tactics, and they were the best that we have to enter a location that is potentially dangerous as this house.
Started, was there any resistance or?
There's no resistance. The suspect and his accomplice were completely cooperative. Again, the male suspect admitted to having ownership of those guns. He admitted to being in possession of the drugs. Again, over a pound of marijuana was seized from that location. And in the warrant, it outlines specifically what we had, what we found on every floor, including a safe of weapons. And $20,000 in cash, possibly even over $20,000. I think the officers at the scene stopped counting. They gave that money over to the DEA, so we're also partnering with federal authorities to determine exactly where this case goes. But as of now, these individuals are held on state charges.
That was going to be my next question. Is there a trail where the drugs come from, where the drugs go, that you're still continuing to investigate?
That's the police work that we're doing right now. We're trying to figure out what was this individual doing, what kind of havoc was he wreaking in this community, where were these guns going, where was this drug profits going, and that's why we've brought in our federal partners.
Were the guns loaded?
I don't know if they were loaded. I don't know. All right. Thanks, guys.